Knowles, you there?
Here I am, fresh from Politicon.
You know, I understand that you were invited to Politicon.
Well, Drew, the reason I was invited to Politicon is because I'm a best-selling author who works in the realm of politics.
Yeah.
So I don't understand.
Wait a minute. I mean, what the hell? You wrote a book with no words in it.
But I wrote one book with no words, and you've written all of the books with all of the best words. So therefore, why on earth would you? No, do you know how I got an invite? This is a real story.
All right, let's hear it.
A Daily Wire subscriber decided to tweet at Politicon and say, hey, is Knowles going? And he kept tweeting at them, and it was this ongoing campaign. It was one guy. And finally, they tweeted at me. They said, all right, already, follow us and we'll send you a message. And they invited me to do a book signing.
So I just want to tell you, when this thing started, I think it was like 2 years ago, 3 years ago, something like that.
Yeah, about 3 years ago.
One of the organizers called me up and said, would you be interested in doing this? And I said, because I'm a team player, you know, I believe in the team. I said to him, I swear this is true. I said, you know, I'd be happy to come, but really we're starting this new thing called the Daily Wire. So why don't you invite us all, and me and Shapiro and Jeremy, I don't think you were there yet. Yeah. They said, we'll do a panel. And he said, great, got in touch with Shapiro, invited Shapiro, and never invited me again.
Well, you know, it's funny, because I think we were having dinner or a cigar or something, and I got the call from Politicon to see if I wanted to go. And then there was a Michael-shaped hole in the wall. I just sort of sprang out on my way to the Pasadena Convention Center.
I said, it's everybody's out for himself. So how was it? Because you may not have heard this, but I wasn't invited. So I'd like to know, how was it? How'd it go?
It was good. I will say, a lot of people were asking for you, and every time it was funnier than the next to explain that, no, you see, I who have done nothing, am here, but Andrew Klavan, he's not going to be able to make it, unfortunately.
I sent those guys to ask for me. You know? Where's Klavan?
Yeah. It was great. There were about 10,000 people there. It was a really big turnout. That isn't the craziest number, though. I have been told in the last 2 years it was 80% liberals or left.
Yeah, the
Democrats.
People who set it up are liberals, I think. Yeah,
people who set it up are liberals. It was actually, I think, the founder of it has no connection to politics. He just did a lot of rock concerts and realized this would be a fun event. You know, it's modeled after Comic-Con, and it's the only place where you get both parties to come to a convention. It is a kind of novel idea, and you get Tommy Lauren to debate Chelsea Handler or Ben and Cenk Uyghur.
Right.
And so that there were 10,000 people, that's a big turnout, but it was not 80-20 Democrat Republican. There were a lot of MAGA hats at this place.
Nice.
When
nice.
You pulled up, there was a honk for Trump set up, and I thought it was facetious, and they were dead serious. MAGA hats galore. If I had to estimate, I would say at least half the people were conservative. Maybe even more than that. I ended up doing a panel with a podcast called Conservatively Unplugged. There was one heckler. I was praying there would be more hecklers. So the whole time I was begging for more. There was only one. The rest were conservatives there. And then for Ben's debate, 3,000 people showed up to watch Ben debate the Young Turks guy, Cenk Uyghur.
Yeah.
The line wasn't just out the door or around the courtyard. It was down the street. There was a line.
That's
moving.
Amazing.
It was unbelievable. They had to move it to their big auditorium there.
Ben against Cenk, that's kind of a battle of wits with an unarmed man, I'm afraid.
I will say, Ben is going to probably be hearing from the International Court for Human Rights. What he did was unforgivable there. Some truly inhumane and monstrous things occurred at that
debate. I would have loved to have seen it, but you know, I wasn't invited. By the way, you said this was based on Comic-Con. I was invited to Comic-Con. Maybe that's it. I'm just a cartoon character.
Well, I will say, one guy came up to me in the debate hall, said, you're Michael Knowles. I said, yeah. He said, you wrote the fake book. I said, yeah. He goes, I can't believe you're real. I thought you were a figment of my troll imagination. I didn't know you were a person. Yeah.
So speaking of which, your show begins today.
It does. It begins today. Ben has named it God Help Us. Yeah. Thank you very much. It is. We begin today. And I'm so happy the timing worked out, because for our first episode, we're going to start with Saint Al Gore, the patron saint of the polar bears. I saw that godforsaken movie, the Inconvenient Sequel. I saw it on Friday night, or Thursday or Friday night in L.A. It was incredible. I'm glad I saw it, actually. At first, I thought it was just typical Andrew Klavan sadism that would bring me out to one of those places. But I go there. It's only playing at two theaters in all of L.A. on its opening night. There were 8 people, including me and sweet little Alyssa, in the auditorium.
The rest of them had been killed by global warming.
That's right. They were the victims.
It was a disaster.
They were the victims. It was so awful.
How was the film?
The movie, I went in there sort of trying to be fair-minded, knowing it would be total nonsense, but maybe a good movie. The first one was a pretty good piece of propaganda, even though it was riddled with lies. But this movie was terrible. It was so bad. It read like a bad nonprofit fundraiser video. They had no joke. At the end, it kind of petered off, and they just had hashtags and go to our website and Facebook page. It wasn't even about global warming. I think he's kind of given up that. He knows that there were so many errors in that first movie, which we'll talk about on the show today. There were errors in this movie, which we'll talk about. But it just became about Al Gore. It was just this pathetic trying to remain relevant, and it didn't work. There was one brief appearance by Justin Trudeau, which was pretty funny in that Justin Trudeau way. I don't think he's a real person either.
No.
But the movie itself, I mean, there's a reason. Nobody is seeing it. I think the Emoji Movie probably has a higher rating on Rotten Tomatoes.
Have you seen the Emoji Movie?
I saw it last night because I said I haven't punished myself again enough this weekend. It is a once-in-a-generation terrible movie.
Wow, really?
I really mean it, yeah. I previously thought the worst movie I've ever seen is a movie called Sans Soleil by Chris Marker, which is about absolutely nothing. This movie is about less. It is – it's actually
– The review should just be like a pile of poop, a picture of poop.
Voiced by Sir Patrick Stewart, The movie is – it's not fun bad, but it is interesting bad. I think it's almost worth seeing for this reason. It has no plot. It has no ideas. It's vaguely leftist, but not even powerfully leftist. And the reason is it's a movie about something that isn't language. It's about that we're like weaning ourselves off language. We're using these stupid smiley faces.
Well, gee, you almost convinced me to see it, but the...
Just maybe I'll try a little harder.
All right, so your show begins today. When does it go online?
In like 5 minutes. I gotta get out of here.
All right, get out of here. Good luck. Break a leg.
Thank you very much.
All right, it's great talking to you. Oh boy, it's but sounded like Politicon was fun, but I wouldn't know. You know why? I wasn't invited. I can't send it. All right.